Hello there. Welcome to part 7 of this tutorial. Today, I'm going to go over how to create and display menus, as well as how to change between certain scenes. Hope you enjoy. Making a menu is one of the more fun aspects of developing. Let's start off by creating a new scene. First, I'll add a control node, which I'll call our main menu. Now we can add a color rect. This will allow us to use a solid color for our background. Remember that this is more of a placeholder. In the layout menu, click on full rect. This will get the background to cover the whole screen. Next, we can add a color. I'm going to be using a dark purple. Use whatever color you think works best. Now that that's done, we can start adding our text. First, I'll add a center container, which will keep our text centered on our screen. Now in the layout menu, click on top wide, then stretch this to be wherever you think your text will be displayed. Now we can add a label. This will display our main menu text. We'll need to type this in the text box too. As you can see, it's being displayed. But that doesn't look much like a title. Let's personalize this a bit. In our theme overrides, we can add a new dynamic font. Then I'll add the same font we used for our score. Next, I'll make the text a bit bigger. Nice, now our text is displayed and is centered on screen. Now we can start adding our buttons. First, let's add another center container. In the layout menu, I'll set this to be in the center of our screen. Remember that I'll want to stretch this to be around where our buttons will be. Next, we can add a V-box container. This will contain the vertical size and orientation of our buttons. Now that that's set up, we can add our button nodes to the scene. I want our player to be able to play or quit the game. Great, now we can make these look a bit better. I'll start with a play button. In the text box, I'll type in the button's name. Now in the theme override menu, we can add a dynamic font. I'll use the same text as our menu. Then I'll increase the size of our buttons. I'm going to repeat this process for our quit button as well. Now our buttons are done, but they're a bit too crowded. I first want to make the buttons a bit wider. We can do this by putting a space before and after the text in our text box. Now I want to add some spacing between the buttons. In our V-Box container node, we can go to theme overrides. I'm going to add a bit of separation, about 80 pixels. There, that looks better. Before we make our game over screen, I want to do one more thing. Let's go back into our button. In our theme override menu, we can go to styles. What this allows us to do is change the way a button looks in different states. For example, when a button is hovered over. I'm first going to change the normal state. Let's add a new flat style box. I want the button to be the same color as our background. There, now only the text is visible. Now I want to change our hover color. Again, add a flat style box. When our button is hovered over, I want the color to be a bit lighter than our background. The last thing I want to do is change the color of the button when it is pressed. Let's add one more flat style box. I'm going to have the button be the same color as our hover color. Now we're going to apply this to the quit button too. Go into the styles menu. I'm going to change our normal state. Add a flat style box. I'll copy and paste the background color. Now I'll add another flat style box to our hover state. Again, I'll copy and paste the color we used for the play button. The last thing I'll do is add another flat style box to our press state. I'll copy and paste the lighter color we used earlier. Alright, enough redundant information. Let's move on. Now we can start adding a game over screen. Because this is going to have the same functionality as our main menu, I'm just going to copy and paste this scene. Click on scene, then on new inherited scene. Remember to inherit from the main menu. Now when we push enter, an exact copy is made. Now we can start making changes to this scene. I'll start by renaming this our game over scene. Now in our label node text box, I'll rename this our game over menu. Now we can go to the play button. I want to rename this our restart button. Nice, now we have a game over menu and it took basically no effort at all. Now we can finally start coding. First, we'll need to add a script to the main menu scene. This is where we'll code our button input. I'll start with a play button. We'll need to add a pressed signal to the main menu scene. When the button is pressed, our main scene will be loaded. Remember that this is where our game is taking place. We're going to need to use GetTree in order to load all the nodes in that scene. Now we'll add another pressed signal to the quit button. When this is pressed, we're going to quit the game. We can use the built-in quit method to close the game window. Now we can go into the player script. When our player's health is zero, we'll load the game over menu. Remember that, because the scene is inherited, we don't have to do any extra coding for the game over menu. The final thing I want to do is have our game open with the main menu. Go into the project settings, then to run. Now we can change our main scene. Remember that we'll need to use the main menu scene. Now when we run the project, our game will open with the main menu. Then if we click the play button, our main scene will be loaded and we can play the game. Now when our player's health reaches zero, we'll get sent to the game over screen. Everything is working, but there is one problem. If we restart our game, both the health and score aren't reset. Let's go into our main menu script. When the play button is pressed, I'll set the global score and health variables to equal their default values. Remember that our health should start at 3. Now each time we restart the game, both our health and score will be reset. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, feel free to subscribe. See you next video.